Most students in introductory organic chemistry in the US are probably majors in something related to biology. Pre-med, nursing, immunology, virology, biochemistry, and chemistry. So I believe that if we're going to teach synthesis in introductory organic chemistry, we should teach DNA and peptide synthesis, because these are chemical methods that are incredibly important to the biotechnology industry. Okay, so let's talk about DNA synthesis. It's performed on a solid phase. The advantages of solid phase synthesis are you keep the product on the solid phase, and to change it, you can use excess reagents, and after they've coupled, you can wash them away. So there's no purification at intermediate steps. You keep repeating cycles. It's really quite beautiful. So in DNA synthesis, we attach the first nuclear base to the resin. It's typically a glass resin via an ester linkage, which later will be cleaved by aqueous ammonia. The first base is coupled to the 3' position, and the 5' OH is protected by a derivative of the trityl group, specifically dimethoxytritiol, DMT. That DMT group is acid sensitive. It's removed with quite a strong acid, typically something like trichloroacetic acid, to give the exposed 5' OH on the resin. And then the key step. The next base is brought in as a protected phosphoamidite. I've shown one here. There's a protection on the oxygen for the PO bond there, which is cyanoethyl. That cyanoethyl group keeps the phosphoamidite in the right form to react. And also there's another DMT at the 5' position. And three of the four bases are protected as well, on the heterocycle somewhere. Okay, so that's coupled in a reaction mediated by a very, very mild acid, tetrazole. After the coupling, that linkage is not particularly stable. So it's a phosphorus 3 oxidation state. It's oxidized to phosphorus 5, maybe by iodine in water. That makes it more stable. And the DMT group is removed once again. And the cycle is repeated in the order in which you need the DNA sequence from 3' to 5'. Let's imagine we've coupled all the bases we need. We still have those cyanoethyl groups. We still have the protection on A, G, and C. And we still have the DMT on the 5' position. So we may remove the DMT and then treat the whole thing with aqueous ammonia, a little bit warm, and that cleaves the linkage to the resin. It cleaves the cyanoethyl groups by what's called a reverse cycloaddition, and it cleaves those protecting groups from A, G, and C. So we collect the DNA then, maybe purify it by precipitation, and it's good to go. Anytime you see a polymerase chain reaction, a PCR reaction, it involves a primer. And that primer is made by solid phase DNA synthesis. Anytime you see a DNA sequencing reaction, you need a primer made synthetically by solid phase DNA synthesis. So these are only two synthetic schemes which apply, though, to millions of reactions, because millions of primers have been made for DNA sequencing and for the PCR reaction. You need to be able to get these things very readily, and that's how it's done. Incidentally, for the people who want all the details, then the protecting groups on A, G, and C are all amide derivatives, and they look like this. I hope that helps you. Thank you very much for listening. Bye-bye.